Investing has always been touted as an important method to keep us financially sound. But the reality is that very few emerging affluent Malaysians know where to begin. In our interview with Standard Chartered's MD and Head of Wealth Management, Samir Sharma, we talk about what holds potential investors back and how the bank's Smart Goals investing platform can fill the gap. Hi, good morning, Samir. First of all, thanks for having us here. Now, before we get into the specifics, maybe you could share with us, how Malaysians fare when it comes to investing. Are Malaysians investing enough? And are there enough Malaysians investing today?
That's a great question. Generally, if you look at it, the economic progress in Asia, including Malaysia, has been pretty good, right? And that's moving the emerging affluent to a far more upward social space right now. This generation is any day way, way better than the previous generation in terms of ownership of assets, education standards that they can offer to the children, and other areas of kind of holidays they can go for, and so on and so forth. Having said that, on investments, that's an interesting area, right? Do they believe that they need to invest and save? Absolutely. That's there. Do they believe they are good at doing that, particularly today? Unfortunately, the answer is no.
Okay.
So a significant portion today still relies on traditional savings to save up, and they believe that will help them through. But the reality is that's not sufficient, and that's definitely not going to help meet their goals financially.
Because you mentioned traditional investing, right? Now, what can you tell us about the trends in digital investing, globally, and how is this actually helping in shaping the culture in Malaysia?
Digital now has become part and parcel of life. It's hygiene more than a nice-to-have thing. Globally, if you look at it, the amount of collaboration happening between tech companies in bringing in new technology, analytics, AI, robotics, and merging it with FIs is an ongoing thing, and it's happening everywhere, including with Standard Chartered today. So for example, I presume we are one of the banks who has launched video-based advice through our advisors in Malaysia. So it's an ongoing trend. I would say significant clients today are very happy managing their banking transactions online than doing it traditionally through branches. So that's a trend that is already happening with Malaysia as well. Given a choice, would they want to invest digitally? I think yes, absolutely. And that's an expectation clients do have. Is that accessible and available today to everybody in a market like Malaysia? The answer is no. It's fairly limited.
Okay.
Right? But it is something that clients are looking forward to. Absolutely.
Right. So a study that Standard Chartered did, right, found that 42% of Malaysia's emerging affluent society feel that they are being held back from making investment decisions simply because there is a lack of advisory. Now, what does this tell us?
That's true. And that's a reality of life, right? So today, investing, if you just want to execute a trade, is easy. You can do it anywhere.
Okay.
You can just go and pick a fund and buy. But when it comes to investing with keeping a goal in mind and getting the right advice for that, given the amount of information overload available in the market today, that is only accessible to a certain group of people who can afford to put in a significant amount of investment money on the table, right? And that's natural because end of the day, to bring in an advisor who has the necessary expertise comes at a cost. So that access is only available to a limited segment of clients. So the emerging affluent definitely would feel the gap, which does exist today.
So how does Standard Chartered address this issue? How does it fill this gap?
So this has been something we have been working towards for a long time, and I'm happy to share that now we have taken our current advisory process, which fundamentally is cutting edge. It is managed using a very strong investment philosophy, and it helps us manage in excess of $50 billion of AUM today. And we've brought it into a digital platform. So what we were doing through advisors, now we'll be able to do it for any and every client through a digital platform. So that reduces the cost to serve, and we can offer it to everybody. And that is something we have launched. So it's called Smart Goals. And the minimum outlay required now, instead of going into hundreds of thousands, is only 400 ringgit. That's all you need to start off, to set your first goal and begin your investment journey with the right kind of advice. All you have to do is be a client of the bank.
Okay.
And as long as you can access SC Mobile, our online banking platform, either through your mobile app or through the online banking platform, you can access Smart Goals. All you need to do after that is be clear that you have a financial goal, which everybody has. So in case you may say, I want to save for my retirement or education or something else, We will help you then understand your risk profile through an interactive tool. That process is pretty easy and simple and intuitive. Once you understand your risk profile, we will advise you on a recommended portfolio allocation that we believe you should be investing in to help you meet the financial goal. And that entire piece, like I said, is backed by our global expertise and advice, and that's how the advice comes to you.
And is the investment advisory generated purely on algorithms?
That could be an option, but that's not how we do it. So fundamentally, algorithms are as good as the human behind it to some extent, right?
Yeah.
And that's more a set of formulas. So our advisory process takes into account research, yes. It takes into account analytics, but it also takes into account the unbiased framework we apply of taking independent views to say what is the right thing to do for clients. And in the given circumstance of the risk profile you have, the tenor you want to save for, the goal you want to meet, what the advice should be. So it's a combination of human and data-driven approach.
Other than Malaysia, is Smart Goals available elsewhere?
So Malaysia and Indonesia were the first two markets for Standard Chartered who have launched Smart Goals.
Right.
And I'm happy to share, we just had opened up the platform and we're not even promoting it to clients yet, but clients started seeing it and started using it to build their portfolios, which is very, very amazing, and we're very happy with that. Gradually, we'll be expanding that to other markets too. Fundamentally, it's Asia, Middle East, and Africa, and that's where we operate, and we'll be expanding the footprint across.
Now, robo-advisory is a thing now in Malaysia, and we have quite a few players out there. Now, how would you compare Smart Goals with the other robo-advisory platforms that we already have in the market?
So, end of the day, there are a couple of things to keep in mind, right? The platforms have to be simple, intuitive, and meet a client's need. So that's one. Two, the advice you offer to the clients has to be based on a certain investment philosophy. So a robo-advisory platform fundamentally is an algorithm which is based on a certain investment philosophy somebody would have built, right? What we are applying today is a combination of taking the digital platform expertise and our existing cutting-edge advisory capabilities and bringing it together. So the current advisory process that we use to manage in excess of $50 billion, which we provide to clients on the high net worth space, is the exact investment philosophy and advice that now we're bringing through the digital platform to all of our clients.